Alright guys, the sealer is flashed off. It's had about half an hour. So, no runs, no muss, no fuss. We're gonna get to cutting these in. So I'm gonna use the same gun. You guys saw me clean it in the last video. We got SRI spot gun. I've got a big cup on it here, and this is a Metalux base coat. It's a 2-to-1. Doesn't cover real good, but it works. It'll work fine with this ground coat. So. Let's get to it here. You don't want to spray this stuff real wet, but you don't want to spray it dry because you'll get a lot of work here. For the inside of a fender, does it really matter? No. Not to me, it doesn't. But on a show car, it would. Probably be, it's hard to tell with this spraying an inside of a fender, but you know, about 50% overlap with your stroke, and you should get full hiding on that primer. It's on there to see where it is. Thank you. Alrighty. That's it for that ground coat. Next step, we're going to put the correct color base coat on there. Probably going to take two coats to hide that enough on the inside of the fender. I did three on the hood of the truck, just because you're going to see it, just to make sure. I don't have a sun gun to check it. So we'll turn you back on in a little bit when it's time to do that. Just another add-on to that last segment, putting that ground coat on. That's fully reduced. That's about two-thirds of a pint left over of fully reduced paint. And when I started, this is a 2-to-1 base coat. So that can would have been about that much paint, and then the rest of it reducer. The matrix base coat's a 1-to-1, so we'll use a little bit less. So doesn't take much, and that's why I like that little gun, because it didn't waste any for me. So, all right, just wanted to show you guys that real quick. That's what we got left on that ground coat. All right, guys, we're ready for our first coat of color on this. We got that ground coat on there. I've got the color in my PPS cup here, and keep using the same gun, same method. Now I know why that coupler leaks. It's starting to give me trouble. Let's spray this at about 24-25 PSI. This time I'm going to sort of tip this fender up before I start spraying. So that I can get that underneath edge, not that you'll ever see it. Actually, you know what? I'm not even going to worry about it. We're just going to roll with it. We're going to spray it the same way I sprayed the rest of it. It's all on the bottom. You'll never see it. So, gun was cleaned after the last color, so we didn't have any cross-contamination. So here we go. Okay, I'm going to let that flash for about 10 minutes, and I'm going to check it to make sure I got decent enough coverage, mostly being concerned with my edges being the right color instead of the ground coat color. And we'll bring you back when it's time to clear it. So here we go. See you.